The Great Rift Valley is the longest fault system in the world, running approximately 5,950 kilometers across the African continent. The story about the Rift Valley draws thousands of adventure seekers and nature lovers from all over the world every year. From its diverse geographical features such as volcanic mountains, hot springs, geysers and beautiful landscapes, lakes to different species of birds and wildlife, the Rift Valley has plenty to offer to tourists.
The Rift Valley region has so much to offer to both domestic tourists and international tourists. First and foremost, the Rift Valley is endowed with a lot of geographical features.
When one thinks about tourism in Kenya, the wildebeest migration and the coastal region are top of the agenda. But the Rift Valley seems to be catching up on tourist numbers. But industry players feel that a lot more needs to be done to market the beautiful rift.
We need more investors to invest more in the Rift Valley region in terms of putting up more facilities. The KTB should invest some money in marketing this region. The Ministry of Tourism through the KTB should do more.
A strong focus here though has been domestic tourism, where the locals take time to visit the sites and are educated on environment conservation.
We do conservation and preservation. There are some animals and birds and plants that are getting into extinct. When people come here, especially the local tourists, we teach them on conservation, preservation of the environment.
The Rift Valley is home to several lakes, the most famous being the shimmering pink lake Nakuru and the hot spring wonder Lake Bogoria.
Along the Rift Valley, we've got several lakes like this here, Lake Baringo, we've got Lake Turkana, we've got Lake Bogoria, we've got Lake Nakuru, Lake Elementaita. Those are the lakes whereby tourists, when they come, they see the difference.
Stretching over 3,600 miles across the African continent, the Great Rift Valley is indeed a natural attraction. Even more, you will find attractions such as volcanic mountains, hot springs, and even lakes such as Lake Baringo that offer a breathtaking scenery. The beauty of Lake Baringo and its surrounding is well known from extravagant sunsets, a stunning array of colorful birdlife, and the giant fishermen canoeing across the lake, creating a magnificent backdrop. The lake itself is home to seven islands.
We have the Kokwa Island, that's the biggest island. Also, in the other side, we have another island known as Devil's Island, the Family Island, and we have the Sematian Island. On the other side too, we have the Rongena and Parmolok. They are facing each other.
Lake Baringo serves as a major economic backbone for the communities around the area. Major sport activities on the lake are boat riding and water skiing, which if well promoted, can boost the economy of the region. And not only do you get a close-up view of the hippos and crocodiles, but you get to feed the fish eagle.
I'm gonna call the fish eagle. And then I have to throw the fish on the water.
One, two, click.
Very close to the lake is the Lake Baringo Reptile Park, established in 2003. The park is the ultimate display of the reptiles of the Rift Valley, from snakes, monitor lizards, and crocodiles.
The park is actually a community initiative, but the technical advisors are the Kenya Wildlife Services and the County Council also, they come in. County Council of Baringo also come in to assist the community in managing the park.
Another tourist attraction on the Rift Valley is the Lake Bogoria. Popularly regarded as the jewel of the Great Rift Valley, it is the most sought-after destination for those who are bird lovers. On the lake, you'll get to see a stunning beauty of the flamingos and a spectacular view of the hot springs. This is one of the world's rare natural wonders, the steaming hot pools and thousands of flamingos on the Lake Bogoria. Nestled in the tranquil bushy acacia trees is the Soy Safari Lodge.
In the lake you will find crocodiles, hippos, and you can do a lot of water sports like boat riding.
In Soy Safari Lodge, we've got facilities like swimming pool, conferences halls, which can take up to 200 packs. Our rooms are 50. Our restaurant can accommodate the same number.
Kenya's tourism industry is undoubtedly a major earner for the country, and it has persistently outpaced its East African neighbors. Industry players from the Great Rift Valley say that the only way the Rift Valley can emerge as a top tourist destination is through continuous marketing.
If we could get more publicity and people can be taught about what we have to offer, it can be a very good destination for Kenyans and other people from other countries in Africa.
Apart from the breathtaking scenery, the area also offers a selection of luxurious hotels and lodges. So, if you're an adventure seeker, a nature lover, or an animal enthusiast, then the Great Rift Valley is the destination for you. For Ziana Mwasia, for the East Africa Business Report, the Rift Valley.